Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is André Kröker from Dagobi. Today I would like to show you how to draw Santa Claus. Yes, I know, this is a very long tutorial, but it's not a tutorial about how to create a circle or a rectangle. It's a very extensive tutorial and you will learn so many things about the pen tool, pencil tool and how to work with the width tool and many other things. So have fun! This is a simple sketch. I've done it with a pencil on paper and after that I make the final drawing with the pencil and then I scan it in Photoshop and paste it in Illustrator. So I start with the opacity, change the opacity to 50% or 30. So next, lock this layer and create a new layer. And I start with the head. So I use a pencil tool. So first I check the options, make a double click on the pencil tool. And I use this options. So in this tutorial I'm going to draw with the mouse. And first change the color, none color for fill and black stroke color. So don't worry about this line. You can use the warp tool. So make sure that the line are selected and now you can change the size of the brush. Hold the Alt key and drag your mouse. So and now I'm going to check the options for the warp tool. Make a double click and I use this settings. So you can try change detail to 1. So if you are happy with the line, please go to Object, Pass and click on Simplify and enable the preview. So try different settings, but I prefer so about 98% and click OK. So next I'm going to use the width tool. So if the line are selected, go to the line and drag, click and drag your mouse. So make this line so next choose again the pencil tool. And draw a new line. And now again, use the warp tool. So if you wish to change the size of the brush, hold the Alt key and drag your mouse, click and drag. And next, go to Object, Path, and choose Simplify. So next, choose again the Width tool. Select the line. Hold the Control key and drag your mouse to select the line and make the line a bit wider. Here and here. Oh, sorry. So next, I'd like to move this anchor point a little bit. So please select both lines, and now I'm going to change the end of the lines. Open the stroke panel and change this to round cap. And continue with the pencil tool to draw the other lines. So I change the stroke width to 1 point, and now choose warp tool. So next, go to Object, Path, and choose Simplify. That's fine. Click OK. And now use the Width tool. And choose again the Width tool. So next, choose again the pencil tool and I draw this line. And this line, I'm going to change the line with the width profile. So go to the toolbar on top and use the first width profile. These are the basic profiles in Illustrator. If you like to change the stroke width in very small steps, please hold the Control key and click on the little arrows. So if you like, you can change line by using direct selection tool. So you can delete some of these points, select for example this anchor point and click on this button, remove selected anchor points, and drag the handles. So the other options is you can use the pen tool and click on this position and make a second point, and now use the anchor point tool, go to the line and click and drag the line. So now you can use again the width tool . Okay, next I'm going to draw the eyes. So this time choose the pen tool and create 3 points. And close the path. So next choose the anchor point tool and click and drag the lines. So next choose the direct selection tool and select this point and convert it to smooth. Go to the top toolbar and click on this button, convert selected anchor points to smooth, and drag the handles. So that's fine. And next, choose the width tool, change a little bit the width. So next zoom in and select the left point and click and drag this little dot, this little circle. And make a copy. Choose the selection tool. Select this eye and hold the Alt key and drag this to the left. Next, open the Transform panel. Go to the Transform panel options and click on Flip Horizontal. So, I recommend you, if you like to move this eye, I recommend you to choose work with this free transform tool. So you can click inside the eyes to move it. If you use with the selection tool, it's not possible. So select the eye and choose the free transform tool, and you can move it better. So that's fine. Next, I'm going to use the same with pencil tool and use width profile as this line. So choose pencil tool and draw this line and change variable width profile. So you can use for these lines, use of course the pen tool. So next, select all the lines. Change the stroke width to 1.5 and apply this width profile. So this for this small lines, I'm going to use this width profile. So choose the pencil tool and draw the lines. So next, select all lines and apply this width profile 5. So and now the eyebrows, choose pen tool and create 3 points. Oh, sorry, I start with this eyebrow. And now choose again the anchor point tool and drag the lines. And now choose the direct selection tool, select the left points and drag these little circles. So that's fine. Now choose free transform tool and scale it a little bit. So next I'm going to make a copy, hold the alt key, click and drag. Oh, sorry. And now open the transform panel and flip this horizontal. You can use the arrow keys on your keyboard to move this. So next, choose again the pencil tool. And now I'm going to work with the width tool. And don't forget to change the start and the ends, the cap to round cap. So So if you don't like the line, you can use a warp tool. And you can simplify the path. And use the width tool. So use the warp tool. And use simplify. And use the width tool. So use again the variable width profile. So next I'm going to use the pen tool and draw these lines. I start here and first I apply only the points. So next, choose the anchor point tool and click and drag the lines. So, and I change the color to none. So choose the direct selection tool and drag these handles. So next choose again the pen tool and continue to draw the lines. Go to the last point, click on this point and create again only Anchor points. And now change tool to the anchor point tool. And drag again the lines. Oh, sorry. So, if that happens, you have to change, convert the points to corner, select the points. And convert these points to corner. And try it again. Okay, it's time to fill this path with color. Apply black color and if you like you can change the anchor points by using the direct selection tool. So next, choose again the pen tool and I draw this line. So deselect all, hold the control key and click on your artboard. And now click and drag your mouse and again. So this time hold the alt key and drag this handle. And click a new point, click, drag, hold the alt key and drag your mouse. So again, click and drag your mouse. And now create a new point, click and drag your mouse and now hold the alt key. And move only this handle and click again on this position and drag your mouse and again hold the alt key and move this handle and close the path. So next you can select this point and change the handle like this. So choose again the pen tool, click and drag your mouse and again. So with the pen tool, create two points. And while you're drawing with the pen tool, you can hold down the Alt key and click on the line and drag this line. So change the color, black color for stroke. And now use the Width tool. And now again, choose the pen tool and create two anchor points. Hold the Alt key and drag this line. And use the Width tool. So in the next few minutes I'm going to draw the beard and I use only the pen tool. So it goes like this. Click and drag your mouse and create a new point. Click and drag your mouse and now hold the Alt key and move this handle, click and drag your mouse, and now again hold the Alt key and make a small handle, click and drag a little bit, and now hold the Alt key and make a long handle. Again, hold the Alt key and make a small handle, very short. Hold the Alt key and create a long handle and make it for the whole beard. So if you hold, while you're drawing with the pen tool, you can hold the Control key and select some of these points, for example this point, and drag this handle and you can continue with the pen tool. Hold the Alt key and create this long handle, or you can hold the Control key to select this point and change the handle, and you can continue with the pen tool. Hold the Control key to change this point. So next, change the color to none. And I continue with the beard. So hold the Alt key to drag this handle. If you like to see what you're doing, if it's necessary to apply black color for the stroke, and I'd like to change the stroke wire to very thin. So hold the Alt key to drag this handle. So if you lose the line, you have to click on the last point and continue with the pen tool. So now choose the direct selection tool and make some corrections. And you can change the color. You can apply fill, black fill color and none color for stroke. So continue with the pen tool to draw these lines, create 3 points. Hold the Alt key. Create again 3 points. And hold the Alt key and drag the lines. So now choose the ellipse tool and create two circles. Hold the shift key for a perfect circle. Change the color and create a second circle. Now I'm going to make some corrections. Choose the group selection tool and I'd like to change the stroke width of the head a little bit. And I'm going to change the stroke width at the ends. So choose the width tool. So you have to move this point and try again with the width tool. Okay, now it's time to apply color. So first create a new layer and I'm going to create a background layer. So move the new layer behind the center and create a big rectangle. And fill this rectangle with red color. So next, lock the background layer and now I'm going to expand all the black lines. So it's very important to expand all lines and I do that by clicking on this little circle to select all, or you can go to select and click on all. Now go to object. Path, you can click on expand appearance, but I prefer to do this by clicking on outline stroke. And now I'm going to use live paint bucket. So I start with white color. And I'm going to change the white a little bit. Like this. So next I use red color. Make it a little bit darker. And now the skin color. Okay, I need the white color again for the hair. So choose the eyedropper tool and click on this white color. Pick the color and now choose again the live paint bucket and fill these areas with white and the eyes and the eyebrows. And you have to fill this with dark red. Okay, next I'm going to expand the live paint. So select the whole group, click on this little circle, and now go to Object, Live Paint, and click on Expand. So next, I'm going to change the black color to brown, to dark brown. So choose the Magic Wand tool, and open the Magic Wand tool panel, and set the fill color to 0, and click on the black color. Or set the tolerance to 5. And change it to dark brown. So next, choose the ellipse tool and unlock the background layer and create a circle. Hold down shift for a perfect circle. So this time I use a gradient, only two colors. So if you remove this sliders, click and drag the sliders. So I need dark red. And change the type to radial and reverse the gradient. So that's fine. And apply a stroke color. So copy this circle and paste it into the center group. Click, go to edit and click on paste in place. And move the circle behind the center. And now choose the pen tool, the add anchor point tool. And create, add two points. 1 point and second. Now choose the direct selection tool and select this point and remove this point. Go to the top toolbar and click on this button, remove selected anchor points. Oh, and delete these points. So now choose the direct selection tool, select that point, hold the alt key and drag this handle. So and change the color, none color for stroke and red color for fill. So please delete these lines. And if you wish, you can create a second circle. So make a copy from this circle and take the first one and scale it. So next I'd like to change the background color. So select the rectangle and I use gray color like this, and I like the first circle and change the stroke color to dark gray. So next I'm going to draw the eyes and first choose the group selection tool and select both eyes. Now go to object, compound path and make a compound path. So you have to search the layer, but you can do that by layers panel options. Go and click on this little button and click on this locate objects. You can find the layer here. So please make a copy of the eye. And now select both layers. And open the options and click on collect a new layer. So now you have to create a clipping mask. So both layers are the same. And create a clipping mask. Select the first layer, the group layer, and now click on this button, make release clipping mask. And now the first layer is the clipping mask and the second layer is the color layer. And now create a circle, choose ellipse tool and create a circle. And fill this circle with blue. So, and the circle are inside the clipping mask. Please remove the stroke color. Now make a copy of the blue circle and shrink this. And fill the circle with black. Not the stroke color, fill color. So you can use brown color if you like. Or try dark brown for stroke. And change these two shapes. Change the color also to dark brown. So that's fine. If you like, you can apply a gradient. So you can change the color by using recolor artwork button. Go to the top toolbar, click on edit, and on this button link harmony colors. And next, create a new circle so you can make a copy of the black circle and change the color. Choose the eyedropper tool and click on this white color. Now choose the free transform tool. So make a copy and now you have to select all the eye layers and make a copy. Please drag this down to the new layers button and now select copies and move this to the left. Okay, next I'm going to draw a very simple shading. So I start with that, choose the group selection tool and click on this white shape. And now choose the knife tool. And cut this shape. So I start here. So next choose again the group selection tool and select the new face and change the color, make it a little bit darker. So continue with this shape, choose again the knife tool, use the eyedropper tool to pick the same dark color. Make the same with the hair. So next I'm going to apply white color and I use again the knife tool. But please don't move the faces. So the leg again. Deselect all and deselect all. So if you wish, you can change the white color, make it a little bit darker. And make the same with the red color of the head. So next I'm going to make the same with the skin, but this time I use the pencil tool and the pathfinder. So I start the ear and first draw a line. So remove the colors and now select the line and this shape. Choose the group selection tool, hold shift and click on the ear shape. So both shapes, both lines are selected, and now open the pathfinder and click on this button, divide. And now you can select only this face and make it darker. Okay, I try this color. And now again, select the ear, choose the pencil tool, select It's very important to remove the colors. And now choose the group selection tool, select the ear, open the Pathfinder and click on Divide. Remove colors. Remove colors and select the ear. So we can use the warp tool to move the lines. And you simplify. It's fine. Click OK. Now choose the group selection tool and select the skin color. So line is selected and skin shape is selected. Open the Pathfinder and click on Divide. So make this color a little bit, change the color a little bit. It's too dark. So deselect all. So select both lines and the skin color and click on Divide. So next I'm going to use a knife tool. So next choose the ellipse tool and create ellipse like this. And fill this, for example, with this color. Make it a little bit darker. And now make a copy. Choose the group selection tool. Hold down the Alt key. So next, select both shapes and open the Pathfinder and click on this button, minus front. And now make a copy, hold the Alt key, and move the shape, open the transform panel and click on flip horizontal. Now again, ellipse tool, and now make a copy, hold down Alt, select both shapes and click again on minus front. So next I'm going to apply a gradient, so choose the ellipse tool and create a circle. Hold down shift for a perfect circle and now apply a gradient to fill color and change the type to radial. And now it's very important to edit the black color. Make a double click on the slider and it's very important to change black to 000. So next, open the transparency panel and change the blending mode to screen. And now you can deform this, make an oval. So if you wish, you can change the white color like this. And move the oval a little bit up and rotate it. Now make a copy, hold down Alt and drag to the left. Go to the transform panel and flip horizontal. And make a copy. And change the opacity so that's fine. And next I'd like to change this shadow color. Choose the magic wand tool. Open the magic wand panel and set the color to 0 and click on the shadow color and make it a little bit darker. This time I do this with a recolor artwork. Go to the top toolbar or you can go to edit, edit colors and choose recolor artwork and make it a little bit darker. Try this. Thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, please press thumbs up. and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.